been hard for you to take care of your mental health?
When quarantine first happened, I had extreme cabin fever. I needed social connection. Being sick in the house for too long was not it. And so, because of that, you know, you'd be stuck with your own thoughts and feelings. So you'd be overwhelmed with countless of stuff. And then plus on top of that, stress. Either it's from, like, outside people or within yourself. And then school wasn't helping at all. And because of COVID, we had to do online learning. And even before COVID was a thing, people were like, oh, yeah, online learning is so much better.
It's
easier, blah, blah, blah. But then when you actually have to be forced into it, it's not at all.
Yeah, it's not it at all.
It was stressful. And especially keeping up with assignments and having to do with intolerable people. So, yeah, that mental health is...
Yeah, school can be stressful in itself. I completely understand you. So, was you taking care of your mental health even though school was stressing you out and everything?
Yeah, hanging out with my friends was a big plus.
Really?
Yes, it was, okay. Even though they do get my nerves sometimes.
Oh.
It's nice hanging out with them because it gets my mind off my own stuff. And when I didn't want to hang out with other people, I would just stay to myself in my room, like watch Netflix, Hulu, or something, and or text, things like that. And I would get started on my schoolwork, especially, and my work, like my job. But, I'm not gonna lie, I'm a procrastinator. So that helps relieve stress sometimes too. But yeah, those are some things. And like sometimes a good cry helps too. Like I just wanna be balled up in my blanket, cry for like a good few minutes, get it all out. Then once I'm good and ready, get right back to it.
So that did help. So everything you just said helped you out. Good. That's good. I wonder who these friends that you're talking about got your nerves.
Yeah, it's not you.
Oh, really?
You're the main one.
Okay. Yeah, if you didn't take care of it, there would be implications, like major implications that affect your schoolwork, your train of thought.
Probably. Usually when I know too much is happening in my head, I can't focus straight. And because of that, I think that's probably one of my main reasons why I procrastinate a lot. It's because there's so much happening, and I'm just trying to track myself and even focus on it. So I think that probably would turn me to. And like with volition-wise, if I hold on to all that stuff inside me and I don't express it out in some way, then it might come off on someone in a negative light. And then now that ruins my relationship with that person because I burst it out because it was so much happening all at once and I couldn't handle it. And that's even worse than fighting your own self. It's a losing connection that you didn't even want to lose in the first place.
So, how can you tell if someone else that you need to help them out with their mental health?
The little things matter.
Oh, yeah, so.
Little things matter. So, if you have like that gut feeling that something's wrong with someone, go along with it. Don't push to the side just because you might not be sure. And then regret the moment when they actually do come out about it that you didn't say something then you could have said something. But you're saying something now, but you could have said something. Always keep that in mind. And if people aren't open, like emotionally open to you, don't force it with them. It takes time because you don't know what caused them to be that way or what can actually get them to be more open to you in particular. So always keep that in mind. But there's always signs, and it's not always the obvious ones. That's why I said the small things matter.
So there are different signs to this. All right, I'll make sure I do keep an open eye out if I.